Hello, long time no see. As I start to make content for this channel again, I thought I would start by unboxing and getting my first impressions on this brand new mini PC that I purchased over Black Friday. This is the Beelink SER5 Max 5800H mini PC. It's still wrapped, so I'm gonna unbox this and we'll take a look at what's inside as well as the initial setup and my initial thoughts of it. I've got a really good deal on this on Black Friday and it was just too good to pass up. All in all, after all the discounts, it came out to $310, which included tax. Right now, it's a little bit more expensive. It's around $400 on Amazon after discounts, but it may go back down to around the $300 mark again. There are a few configurations that you can get for this. For me, I got the 16GB RAM with the 1TB storage, both of which are expandable. I don't plan on upgrading any of those specs now since it's more than what I'm looking for at the moment, but I like that I have that option in the future. Looking at some of its other specs really quickly, it uses a Ryzen 7 5800H CPU, which has 8 cores and 16 threads. For storage, it comes with an installed 1TB M.2 PCIe SSD. You can upgrade that to up to a 2TB SSD. You can add an additional 2.5-inch SSD or hard drive right into the case, which is pretty cool. It has plenty of cooling. There's a black and gray version. I have the Obsidian Black, I believe this is called. It comes with Windows 11. And as I mentioned, it comes with 16 gigs RAM for me, but it can expand it up to 64 gigs, which is pretty cool. And it can simultaneously support up to 3 displays, one HDMI, one DisplayPort, and one USB-C. I don't plan on using more than one most of the time, maybe 2 if I'm doing something heavy, but I'm just gonna stick to 1 for now. It has an audio card, 1-year warranty, and it comes with both Wi-Fi 6 and Bluetooth capabilities. So let's start unboxing this and see what's inside the box. All right, so I have this box here, it's still wrapped, so I'm gonna unwrap it. In the back of the box, it has my exact configurations, which includes the CPU, which is the AMD Ryzen 7 5800H, 16 gigs of memory, 1TB storage, Wi-Fi 6, LAN, input, etc., etc. So this is what the box looks like. It's pretty black. It's hard to see the logo, but there's a big 5 on there. Black on black says SER5. I think this is the best view you're gonna get. So this slides off. I'm gonna take this off. And I have a nice box underneath as well. And this one, I believe, just pops off like this. It smells very chemically as soon as I open this box, like very strongly chemical smell. But nothing to do about that, I just have to let it air out. There is a card here, it says hello. Let's see if I can get that to show, hello. Up here we have the user manual, the SER user manual. I will read through this. And here we have the mini PC unit. Nice straps, click it, take it out. Set this aside for now, and this is what the mini PC looks like. It has some plastic wrapping, and I am going to remove this. There we go. Obsidian black, looks pretty nice, and it's a little bit hard to see in the video, but it looks really nice. Just like a mesh top here. It has a good weight to it. I think it's only about a little bit over a pound, which is nice. In the front, we have a couple of USB 3 ports here. We have 1, 2, 3 USB 3 ports, a USB-C port, the aux port for audio, and the power button here, the red power button. Button that you can poke into to clear the CMOS, if you ever need to do that. On the side here, we have some vents here. On the other side are also vents. And in the back, we have more ports. We have the LAN port. Looks like we have one more USB 3 port, this blue one, and a USB 2 port, this bottom one. And we have 2 video output ports, one HDMI and one display port. All right, I'll put this to the side and see what else is in the box. We have some screws, and this looks like a VESA mount so that I can mount the mini PC in the back of a monitor, which I don't plan on doing. For my setup, we have the AC power cord. Put this to the side. comes with a couple of cables. It comes with a really small HDMI cable. I assume this is useful if you mount your mini PC to the back of a monitor. Seems to be like 6 inches maybe at most. And we have a longer HDMI cable. This is what I'll use to connect to my monitor. And that's it, nothing else in the box. All right, so pretty simple. On the bottom, there are some nice rubber grips here. There's this little red tab here, I think it's to open the bottom panel once I have this unscrewed. So let's get closer and I'll open this up and see what's inside. So on the underside, there are 4 screws here. There are Phillips head screws, so I'm gonna use a small screwdriver to open it up. All right, screws are undone. Now I can pull this and then, yep, it comes off. Just a nice metal plate here. I will mention in the back of this, there's a quick settings button description here. So it says, press delete to go to BIOS and press F7 to go into boot menu. So if you ever forget, it's just written at the bottom, which is nice. So in the back here, we have a fan here, and it looks like there are SATA ports here. So you can just plug in your 2.5-inch hard drive or SSD right directly onto this. And there are some screws here, which I will undo and see if I can open this thing back up and open this up and see what's on the inside. So those also use the same size Phillips head. Okay, so that's the bracket. This is the SATA cable connections. And then here, there is another screw on this side. I will unhook this. Seems to be one more screw in here, in the very corner. And there's one more screw at the corner, so there are 5 internal screws that you need to remove to get this back plate off. I think I finally got it. There we go. Woof, that took a, there's 5 screws here. So after getting all the screws out, this is what the internal inside looks like. This is the fan cable. I'm not gonna plug this because I'm not gonna take anything out. Once I remove this out of the way, there is an M.2 NVMe card here. This is a 1 terabyte SSD. And here I have 2 RAM cards. DDR4 3200 megahertz. Pretty cool. So if I ever need to upgrade, I need to change these out or change this out for storage. Pretty cool. All right, let's put this back together, see if I can remember where all the screws came from. All right, everything is plugged back in. Now I am going to connect the power cable, HDMI cable, plug in a mouse and a keyboard, and we will take a look at what the setup is like, the initial setup is like. So let's see how I will record my computer screen. I'm going to breeze through the initial setup because I don't have a good way to record the screen during this phase, and I didn't realize how washed out it would look by pointing my camera right onto the monitor. The only tip I'll give you here is when it asks you to connect to a network, do not connect to a network and click on I don't have internet. Otherwise, it'll ask you to sign on with a Microsoft account. If you're okay doing that, then by all means go ahead, but I'm going to skip it. All right, now that we're on the desktop, let's actually move on to seeing the screen properly. Alrighty, I have OBS Studio connected. My time is wrong. It's probably because it's in the wrong time zone, but that's okay, I can fix that later. Before I move any further, what I actually want to do is Personalization. The start menu here, the taskbar, and where does that go? Let's see, taskbar behaviors, yeah, center, left. All right, that looks a little bit better. And back to personalization, themes to apply. Sure, dark. All right, this is cool. Okay, I'll leave it at that. So it's a little bit better, more personalized. And while I was waiting, I downloaded a few more things such as Firefox, Crystal Disk Mark, and Cinebench, and we'll look at the results soon. The first thing I did after downloading Firefox is run a speed test here, and you can see that this is my upload and download speed. This is over Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi, so it's Wi-Fi 6 that it's connecting to. I have gigabit internet, so on wired, I expect this to be a little bit higher, around 800-900 megs per second, megabits per second. But this is pretty good. And I am about 3 or 4 feet from the router. Not bad. All right. First, let's look at the system information and see what we have here. So again, we have Windows 11 Pro activated. Great. We have the AMD Ryzen. This is just reinforcing what we already know. You know, it's an 8-core CPU. The one thing I did have to look up is, because this is an APU, an accelerated processing unit, not a CPU and GPU, it's all both combined. I learned that it needs to use some of the memory for its APU, I think for the GPU part, the graphics part. So although I have 16 gigs of physical memory installed, I only have access to about 13 gigs of memory here. And available physical memory is because some of it is being used for the other programs that I'm running here. But not bad, 13 gigs, works fine. And it does look like virtualization is enabled, which is cool. I'm not planning on using it here, but it's a good option to have. Okay, so I'll close this. The next thing we'll look at is the crystal disk mark. And these are just the readings from the installed gigabit M.2 drive. These are also expected, as they said. Those are around 3.5 gigabits per second, or gigabytes per second. And yeah, this looks pretty good, pretty fast. This ended pretty quickly. If we look in the PC here, we can see that, you know, local disk has 886 gigs of 929 gigs remaining. So far, so good. Seems pretty smooth. The last one we're going to look at is the Cinebench. So I ran this on multi-core and it scored 673 compared to other similar CPUs. Of course, the Apple M1 is ridiculous with its score here, followed by this Intel Xeon processor, where we are at number 7. Not bad, not amazing, but not bad. So this is pretty cool. So far, so good. I think this will be the end of my open box and first thoughts of this mini PC. I will say that when I was running Cinebench, it was extremely loud. Not extremely loud, it was very loud with the fans running. I could feel the breeze coming in from all sides, which is nice. And it stayed cool, like the chassis didn't get hot or anything. And it took about 15 minutes to run, and after this was done, it quieted down. It's been quiet for about 20 minutes now. My next steps will be to start installing some of my astrophotography software that I need. And you'll probably find some of that video on my other channel at Astronomy. Check that out if you haven't yet. If you have any questions about anything I covered, let me know in the comments below. I am more than happy to answer to the best of my ability.